Okay, year two. So this is your challenge sheet for today. We'll just have a quick look at it. So you've done a sheet like this before with true or false questions, some questions about the book in challenge one, and then challenge two is a what do you think question. So there's not necessarily a right or wrong answer. It's all about what you think. Okay, so that's a quick look at the sheet. And then what I'll do is I'll get all of the pages that I've read with you so far this week, and I'll put them after this, and you can go through the book again, and then I'll put the sheet at the end. And of course, the sheet is on the website as well. I'm so excited. I'm nearly ready to lay my eggs. I had a wander round the swamp, looking for a nice place to lay them. That's hard, when there are so many big, fierce dinosaurs around. It's just not fair. The biggest, fiercest dinosaurs get everything their own way. They even have days named after them. Like today, T-Day, named after Tyrannosaurus Rex, the biggest and fiercest dinosaur of all. Why can't I have a day named after me? Hypsilophodon Day, it would be. I know that's rather a mouthful, but it could be H-Day for short. The trouble is, I'm not one of the biggest, fiercest dinosaurs around. Far from it. I'm nearly the smallest and one of the gentlest. I do hope I'll manage to look after my babies all right. I just can't wait to see them. Tri-Day. Tri-Day? I ask you, why name a day after Triceratops? Just because she's got three horns and a fancy armoured plate frill round her neck, it's just not fair. She's tons bigger than me, and she has all this armour to protect her against T-Rex and the like. I haven't even got one horn. All I've got are these two little spikes on the thumb of each of my front paws. And they're not much use. At least Triceratops doesn't try to eat me. She only eats plants. But she can be quite a bully. This morning, I had just discovered a patch of delicious horsetail plants, my favourite food, when Tri appeared, horns lowered saying, "Beat it, Hipsy Whipsy." It's a wonder I found anywhere to lay my eggs, but I did. Yes, I've laid them, all 20 of them, green with black spots like last time. I dug a hole in the mud and laid them in a beautiful spiral pattern. I covered them up with bits of horsetail to keep them warm. Oh, how I hope they'll all hatch out. Youth Day. I don't mind my friend, Euphosophorus, having a day named after her. She's another of these armour-plated giants. But she's not a bully like Triceratops. In fact, she's a bit of a star, especially today. There I was, hovering round my new nest, nibbling at some lovely juicy horsetails, when all of a sudden, from out of the tall ferns, a gigantic T-Rex appeared. I froze to the spot. Normally, I would run. I'm quite a nippy mover. But for some reason, I couldn't bring myself to leave the nest and all of my beautiful eggs. T-Rex was just about to pick me up in his razor-sharp claws when Youth charged up and gave him a whack in the stomach with the really cool club which she has at the end of her tail. T-Rex doubled up in agony and lumbered away, clutching his stomach. He seemed to have forgotten all about me. When I thanked Youth, she just said, "Don't mention it, old girl. You'd do the same for me." The trouble is, I couldn't do the same for her. I'm just too little, and all I've got to fight with are the silly spikes on my thumbs. Thank goodness my eggs are all right. Comp Day. Tragedy has struck. All my eggs have been eaten. I was guarding the nest when T-Rex appeared again. This time, there was no Youth around to protect me. I forced myself to leave the nest and run for my life. I had to run for miles. It's a good job I'm so fast on my feet, or I would never have got away. But when I got back to the nest, it was surrounded by a gang of Compsognathi, all smacking their jaws and licking their lips, with egg yolk trickling down their chins. I hate comps. They are even smaller than me. Yet they have a day named after them. I suppose it's because they go around in a nasty, fierce gang, hunting for lizards and insects and dinosaur eggs. This is just what happened to my last lot of eggs. I am beginning to wonder if I will ever have any babies. Life is very hard. Meg Day, several weeks later. Sorry about the long gap. I meant to keep this diary every day, but I've been too upset. Even when I realised I was ready to lay some new eggs, I didn't feel much better. But today has been so amazing. Like some weird dream that I simply must tell you about it. This morning, it seems like a lifetime ago, I was wandering around, yet again looking for a good egg-laying spot, when I heard a familiar crashing sound coming from the tall ferns. It sounded suspiciously like T-Rex, but it wasn't. It was a Megalosaurus, another of the awful giant meat-eaters. Once again, my little legs went into action, but the ground was covered in puddles and rocks. Meg could leap over these, but I had to splash through the puddles and dodge around the biggest rocks, which slowed me down. I shouldn't have glanced over my shoulder, but I did. And that was how I tripped over a rock. I picked myself up quickly, but I had hurt my leg. I could only limp along. This is it, I thought to myself as the footsteps behind me grew louder. I splashed into yet another puddle and then realised it wasn't a puddle. Not an ordinary one, anyway. It was much deeper, more like a well. I was being sucked under the water, so I wasn't going to be eaten. I was going to drown. But I didn't feel as if I was drowning. Strangely, I didn't seem to need to breathe at all. I closed my eyes and let the water take me down, deeper and deeper. So make your way through these questions. You can either print off the sheet, which will be on the website, or you can write it in a book or on a piece of paper that you have at home. And then we'd love to see your answers, so feel free to send them in to us. That would be great.